So BER, or benign early repole. What is benign early repolarization? It's an ECG abnormality which shows an early repolarization pattern, and as the name suggests, it's likely benign. Now, I know that's a circular definition, so let me answer a bigger question. That's why should we learn about it? It's a common and pretty convincing STEMI imposter. It's caught more than one person. So it can be found on the ECG and used to discern whether or not a patient's chest pain is cardiac in origin. If you know what you're looking for, you can say, hey, this is more than likely BER. So one of the things we need to understand is where we see BER. We usually see this in the younger and the athletic populations, sometimes in random people, but more often than not, the younger and the athletic people, okay? Where we don't see it, or where we are very unlikely to see it, is in patients over 50 years old. So if your patient is over 50, chances are their ST elevation may be related to an MI. But let's talk about the differences between BER, where you can almost say the age of the patient is irrelevant when you find certain things in the rhythm strip itself, okay? So some of the characteristics of BER is that the ECG is stable from one ECG to the next. So you run serial ECGs and nothing's really changing, or the changes are very, very minuscule. That's one characteristic of BER. Remember, the hallmark of disease is change over time. And I don't know if that's faster anywhere than it is with cardiac problems, okay? Especially the acute MI. You also will notice some notching at the J point. Like pericarditis, there will be ST elevation everywhere. And there are some things with the ECG and BER that are not typical of a true MI. So let's say you have an occluded right coronary artery, the inferior leads will show ST segment elevation. Your lateral leads then should show ST segment depression. And one thing you will notice about the BER ECG is that you don't find any ST segment depression. You don't find any reciprocal depression anywhere on the ECG, regardless of where you find the elevation. So having a look at your typical BER here, don't forget the smiley face sign. So let me show you what I mean. If you look here, you can see some standard morphology, both a concave and a non-concave waveform, all right? In BER, as you'll notice on the left side, it will take on sort of a half of a smiley face's mouth whenever the J point slurs back up into the T wave, okay, versus with the traditional STEMI with a transmural MI, it sort of makes more of the left half or right half, if you're going anatomically, of the frowny face, okay? So let's take a look at a BER ECG right now. So the ECG in front of you, you'll notice some diffuse ST elevation, which, you know, you're already here because you think it's not a transmural MI, but you could say, well, Greg, this could be pericarditis, all right? Well, let's take a look at it and see why it's not, okay? So the very first thing, we notice our smiley face signs, all right? Then we notice the notching in the J point, as we said, is characteristic of BER. And then moving forward from there, we can see there's ST elevation everywhere. Now, you notice that there is going to be an absence of the knuckle sign, which is something I'll go over in a future video for pericarditis, all right? So in conjunction with an ECG that looks like that, your patient also won't look like they're having an MI. They won't have a Levine sign throwing. They won't be diaphoretic. They won't have any pallor, and their vital signs will remain stable. All right, and that's a brief rundown on BER. Get out there and practice. Like and subscribe.